Alright, and welcome back. So, still working on certs, still working on simplifying them, but now we're dealing with some slight complications, alright? And you're already looking at it going, oh my goodness, Mr. Taylor, what is going on? But it is not so bad, it is not so terrible. Okay? So, we want to simplify these down. How are we going to do that? Just like fractions. Okay? Just like fractions. We're going to gather like terms together. So you can already see that here I've got square root of 3, here I've got square root of 3, here I've got the square root of 5, here I've got the square root of 5. Alright? Pretty easy to start off with. Okay? Now, all we're going to do, gather those like terms together. Okay? The square roots stay the same, just like they would if they were denominators, but we add the numbers together. 2 and 6 becomes 8. As big as I wanted. The square root stays exactly the same, so it's still the square root of 3. No worries there. And now we've got, so we've got positive 4, take away 5. Right? 4, take away 5. Is minus 1, right? Not 1, minus 1, okay? That's how those two come together. And our radical stays exactly the same, right? Just to be pretty, okay? I don't need that 1 there. 1 multiplied by the square root of 5 is still just the square root of 5. Alright, that's it. Just like if you were putting fractions together. Nothing too scary there whatsoever. And then you just leave them like that. Okay, you can't bring two different radicals together. They have to stay apart. Okay, simple as that. Now, let's get a little bit more complicated. Okay. This has worked example 7. Even though this is more complicated, it's just a couple more steps to what we're doing. And it's steps that we already know how to do. Alright, there's our expression. We've got to simplify it. So where are we going to start? First of all, we want to simplify these square roots. They're awfully big. And there's nothing similar about them at the moment. But if we simplify them individually, we might be able to find something we can work with. So, set up some brackets. Some factors that 75 splits into that is a perfect square, or at least has a perfect square. A perfect square being a non-surd number, that's a perfect square. 25 is definitely a perfect square. 25 multiplied by, I do believe 3 should give us the answer we're after. Yep. Alright, so that's the first one. Another set of brackets for the next one. Now 6 and now 2 numbers multiplied together to get 12. Well, I'd say 4 would be one. What's the other number? 3. Absolutely. So the square root of 3. All right, we're getting somewhere. Now, once again, for 8, I reckon we can use 4 again. And we'll use 2. And I'll put some brackets around that. All right. Last but not least, 4 and 3. Can we do anything with that? Can't get any more simple than that, so we just leave that one as it is. It is already a simple third. It's not simple enough third right now. Okay, next step. See if we can solve some of these. So, 5 times the square root of 5. What's the square root of 5? Punch that in your calculator. You should find that it is 5. And 5 times 5 is 25. So, quick little hop leap. 25 square root 3. So that's from square root of 25 is 5. 5 times 5, 25. Take away from that. Square root of 4 is 2. 2 times 6 is 12. 12 square root 3. Plus, square root of 4 is 2. 2 times 2, 4. 4 square root 2. And still sitting out on the end, 4 square root 3. Okay. Should be getting pretty close to our last step here. What do you reckon it is? If you said gather like terms, spot on. Good work. Now, we've got square root of 3, square root of 3, and square root of 3. So let's bring them all together. 25, take away 12, is 13. 13 plus 4 is 17. So, 17 square root 3 plus our little guy on the end. 4 square root 2. That's it. Simple as that. Couple of steps involved there, absolutely. Absolutely. But nothing too complicated at all. If you know the steps. And if you look at it like a fraction, start looking at it like a fraction, and the work that you've done with fractions in the past will help you. A lot. So, things to remember for the exercises that we're going to do. What is a surd? Surd is an irrational number which can be written with a radical sign. Make sure I use my commas. Simplify. Need. Yep. I have to excuse that. Square roots, one of which must be a perfect square. Perfect square is like our square root of 25 here. That comes down to 5. Yeah? Perfect answer, perfect square. Don't forget, not all surds can be simplified. Don't forget our little equation, that if you have the square root of a number multiplied by another number, that is exactly the same as the square root of the first number multiplied by the square root of the other number. Right, some perfect squares to remember. Okay, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, and 64. There's many, many more than that, but that's where I'll stop it for now. Only like certs can be added and subtracted. Okay? Just like a fraction. Only with like terms. Only with like terms. And all certs must be in simplest form before you add or subtract. Alright, that's going to make your life much, much easier. Much easier. Don't forget, use your calculators, especially for these square roots. Alright? They will help a whole bunch.